Meditations, meditations, meditations. There are so many meditations. So many meditations that you can do. There are so many very basic meditations. The very basic meditations. Controlling your mind, thinking of nothing. Trying to stop your thoughts. Trying to control your breaths for so many counts, for so long. The longer you can sit, the more you know. Things like this. There are dancing meditations, there are singing meditations, there are chanting meditations. There are meditations where you focus upon an object or something like that. There are meditations of mindfulness. There are meditations of presence. There are meditations of all kinds of things that you can meditate upon. There are katas and there are yoga postures and asanas or whatever you call them. You have all of these. There are meditations, however, which are harder to find. So, let's talk about those. The first one that I want to talk about is an adopt a master of meditation. To adopt a master, you must learn a master. To learn the master, you must study the book. Not the book about the book. The book itself. It doesn't really matter if the book is translated into a language like English. Because if it is English, then it's okay, still, it's gonna say the same thing as it said in Chinese, or in Aramaic, or in Greek, or in Hebrew, or, you know, Arabic, you know, it does not matter. So you find a master, you learn about the master, you learn everything you can about the master. You study them for a while, you know, maybe several years. Probably at least for a dedicated student who will study them for several years. And then you are ready. And when you do this, you begin to take on a meditation that is a method. It is a method act. It is how a method actor connects with his query. It is also how the Methodist Church connects with theirs. It is called the method of adopting the master. So you look at the master, you study them, and then you try to be like them, like all the time. Or just think for very long stretches of time at once about how they think, what they would think, how they would feel about a certain situation, how they feel about the things that are in front of you now. Not things about how they would feel, but you can do anything you want. You can think about how they felt in their life, how they would feel if they saw what has been done since their life, how they would feel if they saw the world as it is today. You can think any of these things. This is an adopt a master meditation. It's very good. There is a master meditation called Infinity Everywhere. It is like the master meditation of the concrete. And even the concrete, you can do it inside your house with carpet. But this meditation is like that, but it is to see the infinity. There is an infinite amount of information around you at all times. You cannot ever look away from infinity. There will always be it, even if you are in the most blank room with the least amount of distractions. There will still always be an infinite amount of things, exactly, that you can look at, like a shadow on a wall. Just one shadow on a wall from one speck of the wall where the speckle was raised. That is the thing. A shadow on a wall. There are millions of those everywhere, beyond anyone who can count. And if you walk in any direction, if you change your perspective at all, you're going to get more. This is infinity everywhere. How do you not understand infinity if it's everywhere? I don't understand. So, then you have the opportunity to arrive at universal awareness. If you have meditated on everything enough, you can do the meditation of Brahma or Allah. You can use the meditation of the universal mind. You can use the meditation of the universe itself. You can try to see the universe as it unfolds from what you call the Big Bang or whenever it began. to know. You just put it in your hand. You just to imagine the universe in your hand. Just in your hand, there is the universe right in front of you. It is doing all of its things. You can see the whole entire history of humanity and the world in front of you. You can see all of the histories of all of the other worlds. You can see the entire construction of the universe built on top of itself, always flipping in and out of dimensions that are constantly linked by chains of energy that just don't even have occupation of space and time, because there is only empty space and time. There are just flashes in a otherwise darkened nothing. Yes, all mysticism leads to unity. All mysticism has led people to the rainbow and people to numerical expressions of Kabbalistic ways of understanding books and reading poems and thinking about the same exact types of things. This is mysticism. It is unity. Will lead you to the same place, no matter who you are and what language you speak.